Alleluia, 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 alleluia. He is risen, he is risen, he is risen, alleluia. He is risen, he is risen, he is risen, alleluia. I will praise him, I will praise him, I will praise him, alleluia. I will praise him, I will praise him, I will praise him, alleluia. Good morning.
Good morning, everybody. How's the sound? Maybe.
Yeah, good.
Little, okay. How's everybody doing on Zoom? Hello.
Hello.
Welcome, dear siblings in the risen Christ. Though we reside in the not yet world where God's kingdom is still being ushered in, gratitude still fills my spirit. For already Jesus has drawn us to himself and holds us close. Already we have the promise that in death and as in life we belong to God. Already the Holy Spirit is at work in solidarity with us. So I invite you to take this moment with me to let gratitude grow and glow within you. And lift it up with me to the God who lives. And no matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, you are welcome here.
I didn't see this little tiny mic. Good morning. And welcome. And if you are a visitor, please fill out the little card in front of you on the back of the pew, and if you care to, and put it in the offering plate. We are having a potluck afterwards, so any visitors are welcome to come to that. The bathrooms are through the door and across the hall. Besides the potluck, we are having an ONA 2.0 workshop beginning at 12:30. And I'm sure if you didn't RSVP and you'd like to attend that, there will be a way for you to do that. It's just about copies, so we can always share. So please, if you want to attend that, please do. It's sponsored by the Juniper Formation of the UCC. And there's a book club that will meet tomorrow, the 8th at 1 p.m. here in the vestibule. And if you haven't read The Kingdom, the Power, and the Glory by Tim Alberta, you can still come because plenty of people know all about it, so they wouldn't mind if you came. Sophia's has begun their 6th annual hygiene products collection to help women in exceptional need as vetted by Help and Hope Center. We'd love your help collecting things like floss, deodorant, toothbrushes, lip balm, and more. There's a full list in the newsletter that will be put into beautiful cloth bags sewn by Martha Sprague, and I have seen those. They are beautiful. Sample hotel sizes or full-size products are welcome. On April 27th is our twice yearly highway cleanup, and that's during Earth Day week, so it even makes more sense that we would clean up from 9:30 to 11:30 a.m. Remember, we are supposed to do this 2 times a year in order to maintain our road signs. So if we don't do that, they're going to take our signs away. That's how it works. Which promote community awareness of our church and the great things we do for our community. There will be morning treats provided. All are welcome. To participate, let's keep the roads. All are welcome to, that was on the second page. All are welcome to participate. Let's keep the roads around our beautiful church equally as lovely. Bags and safety vests are provided. They're nice, bright orange. You're so pretty. Bring a friend, neighbor, grandkids. There's plenty of garbage to go around. That's true. I've seen it. Please sign up with Peggy Campbell in the office. And one more, Spice Project will be packing spices on April 21st to be delivered to Project Worthmore. All are invited to join in the fun. Bring your apron. Did I miss anything? Does anybody else have any announcements? Eileen.
Good morning. I wanted to announce that the fair is coming up really soon, and I have a official looking sign-up sheet that will be downstairs on the bulletin board for those of us who want to sign up for a committee or something to do. And the next three Sundays, I'd like to make teeny weeny announcements about the fair, about different parts of the fair. It is really coming together beautifully. Music and animals, I mean, two of my favorite things, and all kinds of artisans are signing up. It's going to be great. So I just wanted to let you know the sign-up sheet's going to be downstairs on the bulletin board.
I think that's it.
Morning, UCC Parker Hilltop. Please rise in body or spirit and join in the call to worship found in your bulletin. We gather here and now, separated in space and joined in one body, fractured by discord and united by love, to worship God, to open ourselves to God's voice, to grow towards God's will together. Come, let us worship God. Please remain standing if it is comfortable for you to do so, and let us sing our opening hymn from the Black Hymnal number 290, The Strife Is O'er.
Red hymnal. Okay. Hey, there's only two. Well, three, actually.
Alleluia. Strife is o'er, the battle done. Now is the victor's triumph won. Oh, let the song of praise be sung. Alleluia, alleluia. Jesus has his foes dispersed. Let shouts of holy joy outburst. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. The three sad days are quickly sped. Christ rises glorious from the dead. All glory go our risen head. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Bound chains of steel, two bars from heaven high portals fell. Let hymns of praise his triumph tell. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Hi, I think it is time for the time with the next generation. So if you're in the next generation and you'd like to come forward, please do so. Awesome. Oh, you can have it now. Now I have my own. All right, how's it going, everybody? I have something to share with you, which is just a rock from Kansas. It's from my family farm in Kansas, and it's a little bit of a fossil situation. You can see here a seashell fossil if you look kind of closely. So that's my rock from Kansas that I have to share with you. And it's a rock. But I wanted to talk today about sharing and I think sometimes we think about sharing as just like our stuff, you know, like we're going to share a toy or a game or we're going to share a treat, right? But what are some other things that we can share? Any ideas from the next generation? Or let me ask a simpler question. What do you like to share?
Maybe like clothes, like with my best friends.
Oh my gosh, yes, absolutely. Yeah.
Kindness.
Yes, thank you, Izzy.
Ducky.
Ducky, yes. You don't have to talk if you don't want to, but you can. The question is, what do you like to share? Okay. Would you like to share your name with me?
I'm sure everyone knows my name besides you.
Besides me. What's your name? But I don't know it.
Just saying.
Yeah, what is it though?
Michael.
Michael. Okay. Hi. And then what's your name?
Miss Maggie.
Maggie, hi. I'm Quinn. Michael, I'm Quinn. Izzy, I already know you. What's your name?
Lily,
thanks. Okay. Well, the other thing that I just wanted to point out is that just like you can share your stuff, like Izzy said, you can share kindness and you can share your name with people and you can share your time and your feelings. And I want you to remember always that your time and your feelings are really important. They're as important as your possessions. And the way that you are careful with maybe who you share your possessions with, you can be careful with who you share your time and your feelings with, because your time and your feelings are a gift. They are as big of a gift as any possession you can ever have. So just remember how special you are and how precious your time and your feelings are. And now we can do the thing. I'll let you guys take the lead because I messed it up last time.
We are wonderful.
We are wonderful.
We are kind.
We are kind.
We are brave.
We are brave.
We are loved.
We are loved.
Yay, God! All right, thank you for your patience. Thanks, Izzy.
Good morning. Now's the time for sharing joys and concerns. Eileen Enterline requests prayers for her strong and kind brother Bill in Tennessee, who is struggling in his battle with kidney cancer. Dick Shear requests prayers for client and friend Landon, incarcerated and awaiting trial in Texas. Continued prayers for Jack Norden and Martha Spriggs' grandson, Rory, as well as all of our military and their families. Bob and Holly J, the Eliason family, who I believe celebrated the life of Pam's mother in Montana yesterday, and Al officiated with that service. Kind of a whole circle there. Heidi Bailey's cousin Debbie during her cancer treatment, Hannah Kloiber and the Manchester family's friends of Desiree and Jeff, Melissa Kelsey on her pending knee surgery, Al and Artie Thompson as they settle in and unpack, Timothy Courtright as he works in his new job and continues his health and wellness journey, the Hopper family, Brooke Albright's dear friends, and the Bailey family. Does anybody either in person or on Zoom have anything to share?
Hi, I just wanted to ask for prayers for my older son and his family. I've mentioned before my grandson, Evan, who's 16 now, is really struggling with some mental health issues, and he could really use everyone's prayers. So I would really appreciate it if you could do that for him. Thank you.
I like to wish concern that if there are any of the congregation or any friends and family that are outside of Colorado visiting Texas, Ohio, or elsewhere, I just like to wish the total eclipse of the heart.
Okay,
I think
thank
that's
you.
It.
Total eclipse of the heart. Still waters run deep, folks. Please remain seated as you prepare for our prayer time. Afraid, lift up your voices, the Lord is near. Lift up your voices, the Lord is near.
For this good, good earth that takes such good care of us when we take care of it, we give thanks. For the pastor, musician, church staff, volunteers, and congregants, we give our heartfelt thanks. For the chances we've had to draw together to serve our neighbors or study, we give thanks. For Black, Indigenous persons of color, LGBTQIA plus persons, and others who take the hells into which their oppressors throw them and transform them into Edens, into refuges for their people, where they can unite, rest from hatred, and create incredible things, we give thanks. And finally, for those who find gratitude hard to muster up right now, we pray for their courage to reach out to community for the support they deserve. And we lift up whatever prayers burn hottest in their hearts. O God who lives, O God who brings to life, O God who sustains us evermore with love. May our gratitude for what already is beget the energy to act. Our thanks for creation moving us to environmental justice. Our thanks for our church leaders and volunteers moving us to participate however we are able. And may our dissatisfaction with how much is yet broken fuel our drive to make your kingdom come, your will be done, to demand justice for Black lives, to demand safety and thriving for trans youth and adults, to demand resources and respect for the disability community, for the incarcerated, for border crossers and Indigenous peoples, and for all who are most disenfranchised by our society. Together we lift these prayers to the God who draws all peoples to Himself. Please join me in the Lord's Prayer, saying whatever words you find most worshipful. Creator God, thank you. Hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into the time of trial, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
In the Lord I'll be ever thankful. In the Lord I will rejoice. Look to God, do not be afraid. Lift up your voices, the Lord is near. Lift up your voices, the Lord is near.
Today's scripture reading comes from Acts chapter 4, verses 32 to 35, from the New Revised Standard Version, updated edition. The believers share their possessions. Now the whole group of those who believed were of one heart and soul, and no one claimed private ownership of any possessions, but everything they owned was held in common. With great power, the apostles gave their testimony to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great grace was upon them all. There was not a needy person among them, for as many as owned lands or houses sold them and brought the proceeds of what was sold. They laid it at the apostles' feet, and it was distributed to each as any had need. Here ends the reading. Let us seek to apply these words to our lives.
Hey, happy Easter.
Happy Easter.
Wait, wasn't that last week? Well, yeah, but today we celebrate the second Sunday in the Easter season, which is also known as Eastertide. We actually get to celebrate Easter for 7 weeks until late May, when we will celebrate Pentecost. So much celebration. While we are celebrating Eastertide, the texts given to us by the Revised Common Lectionary this year center around encounters with the resurrected Christ, as told in the Gospels of Luke and John, as well as the adventures of the early church, as portrayed in the book of Acts, which is what we are drawing our message from today. The early Christian community in Jerusalem in Acts 4 sought to meet each other's needs as a reflection of the bonds of community, enlivened by the Holy Spirit, and that was their witness to the resurrection, their love for one another. And to me, that's beautiful and inspiring. But as much as I might wish it, this reading is not exactly a set of instructions for how to dismantle today's systems of globalized industrial capitalism in favor of the beloved community through the voluntary redistribution of wealth. It's not what we get today, unfortunately. At least, I don't think that's how today's passage from Acts is supposed to work. The Bible, it seems, is woefully short of practical, prescriptive solutions for how to set up a just society. Instead, we get a variety of stories of how believers of the past tried, and sometimes failed, to live according to the principles of justice-making neighbor love. In the words of the Pawn Stars TV show, "You want a utopia? Best I can do is a narrative of how one early Christian community wrestled with the economic injustices of their day." Thank you. You're very patient with me. As it turns out, the question of how we live out our faith is one we have to figure out for ourselves. The Bible gives us answers, but they're complicated answers. For example, the inspiring words of Acts chapter 4 about how they shared all things in common are followed by the chapter 5 story of Ananias and Sapphira, a wealthy couple who one after the other dropped dead at Peter's feet after lying about the total proceeds of the sale of all their goods that they were supposed to turn over to the apostles. So, you know. apparently wasn't any easier for them than it is for us. Clearly, the practical reality of sharing all things in common, no more simple and easy back then than it is today. But the answers are there within the Bible and within ourselves. Biblical scholar F. Scott Spencer explains, for the early church depicted in Acts, the resurrection of Christ is a creative force of community formation and fellowship. According to our text, the apostles had borne the testimony to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, thereby mediating great power, which in Greek is dynamis, and great grace, charis, upon all who embraced their message. So the apostles' community was in many ways the embodiment of Jesus' resurrection. The bonds of fellowship that they forged in the early days of Christianity carried the miracle of new life beyond the empty tomb and out into the world. The power of their message of shared rebirth is what built the foundations of our modern church. So how do we live out our faith in the resurrected Christ today? As your pastor, I want to lift up and celebrate the practices that have held this community together and have helped this community of faith deepen their faith through turbulent times and personal tragedies. And I hope to expand and deepen those bonds through a few new things as we share our spiritual walk together, if I can. Maybe literally a spiritual walk together. Let me know if you are interested in forming a contemplative hiking group. Today's passage explains why they shared all things in common, so that no one was in need. They were focused on the needs of their local community here. They were not trying to solve every problem in the world, but the mission was that no one was to be in need in the immediate community. The closer bonds of community, the easier it is to know what people need. And the closer the bonds, the greater the desire to meet those needs, to care for one another. This caring is how we still see Christ's resurrection among us today. And we celebrate this resurrection every day that we care for each other, every day that we live according to the law of love. Amen.
Hymn number 433, and one of those three hymnals, I'm not sure. Thank you. This is a community, and you are helping me. Thank you. You may stand if you're able.
In the bulb there is a flower, in the seed an apple tree, in cocoons a hidden promise, butterflies will soon be free. In the cold and snow of winter, there's a spring that wants to be unrevealed until its season, something God alone can see. There's a song in every silence, sinking word and melody. There's a dawn for every darkness, bringing hope to you and me. From the past will come the future, what it holds a mystery. Unrevealed until its season, something God alone can see.
Beautiful.
is our beginning in our time infinity. In our doubt, there is believing in our life eternity. In our death, a resurrection at the last of victory. Unrevealed until its season, something God alone can see.
Now look at the shirt. As we prepare to pass the offering plate, both real and virtual, now is the time to reach into your purse or wallet. And don't forget that extra $1 bill for missions. And since I would not ask you to do anything that I wouldn't do, I will match the first five $1 bills in the plate. Okay, Acts 4, verses 32 to 35, in the NIV version of the Bible, the one I look at, the believers share their possessions. This ought to be a slam dunk, not to be too timely, Paul, for the invitation to give. Do like the apostles did, share all that you have with each other and the poor, right? Well, there's no evidence as to how well that worked. Apparently, I should have read on. next time I will. How well that worked for them, but for my brother and his wife, who tried communal living in the early 70s, and I'm here to tell you that it was a rather dismal failure. It's one thing to share the bills and the cooking duties, but beyond that, the lines begin to blur rapidly. Enough of that. So what is my takeaway from this reading? In today's world, I think the passage can be summed up as, live generously. Yes. That was without the mic. Use your gifts that God has given you, time, talent, and treasure, to help yourself and each other on the journey. Spread your less tangible gifts of love, acceptance, understanding, forgiveness, and welcome abundantly to the children of God that you meet along the way. For we are all God's children. In my sister-in-law's funeral this week, I was asked to lead a responsive reading. The penultimate prayer was, for all who work for a more just and compassionate world, who believe that love is love, that Black Lives Matter, that trans rights are human rights, and that what we do for the least of our brothers and sisters, we do for all of us, we pray to our God. God, hear our prayer. Thank you.
please stand? Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise God, all creatures here below. Praise God above you, heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. From all that dwells below the skies, let songs of hope and faith arise. Let peace, goodwill on earth be sung. Through every land, by every tongue. Amen. Number 253 in one of those books. Black? Good. See, I'm just making sure you're awake. If you can help me. Now, we're not going to sing the French. I'm sorry, some of you will be very disappointed. When you get to Quebec, you could probably hear that, but not here. Yours is the glory, resurrected one. Endless is the victory you o'er death have won. Angels clothed in radiance rolled the stone away. Conquered is the grave in which our body lay. Yours is the glory, resurrected one. Endless is the victory you o'er death have won. See, it is Jesus has appeared. Do not doubt at all, for nothing you fear. Let the church with gladness hymns of triumph sing. Tell it without ceasing, death has lost its sting. Yours is the glory, resurrected one. Endless is the victory you o'er death have won. Still frightened, one whom I adore. Jesus lives again, gives peace forevermore. Jesus is my victory, life and strength and head. Jesus is my glory, nothing shall
shall I dread? Yours is the glory, resurrected one. Endless is the victory you o'er death have won.
Revitalized by our worship, let us take the new life that Jesus gives us freely out into the world, a world that is still hurting, a world where pain and grief and death still pervade creation. There is so much work to do, but we rejoice to know that the God who creates, redeems, and sustains us works alongside us, empowering us to roll back the stones on every tomb. Thanks be to God.
Bye, everybody. Nice to see you.
Thank you.